there, folks. Show number 585. My name is Larry Herb, Xbox Live's Major Nelson. And that means that it's that tone either means one of two things. I have Outlook open, or in this case, the show has started.
Yay!
Those voices you hear, that's right. We have Laura with me. Hi, Laura.
Hello, Larry.
And then sitting across from you, thank you for finding time in your day to join us.
You're
and
welcome.
Sitting across from you is Jeffrey.
It's been a dog's age, Larry.
This is actually a critical show. Okay, go to Snopes right now and fill out the page, because here's what I'm going to tell you. You know, good old Albert Pinella, who we've had on the show in the past.
Don't know.
There's a lot of concern that he and Laura are the same person. Well, joining us in studio live with Laura is Albert Pinello. Hi, Albert.
Hi, I'm not Laura.
It's nice to see you. This is now. You guys, seriously, you haven't been on the you haven't been together in.
We've never been on the show together.
Right.
You always seem to come on the show when I'm on vacation or something
right.
like that.
Right.
I would argue that you always seem to avoid the show when I come on the show. So I think it's all a matter of
either way. Either way, it's been remedied. Either
yes.
way,
so
there's same place at the same time.
A couple things going on here. We have we've moved. We are now in a. They built me the studio.
Storage D.
So if you have it in your mind that Major Nelson Radio is created in a studio worthy of Larry's radio heritage, it is now.
It
Before
is now.
That, yeah. it was filmed in a broom closet, yeah. a glorified broom closet.
Yeah. My kitchen table.
Conference room.
Conference room.
Normal conference room.
I've done
rooms.
It in a closet. Pretty much anywhere on the planet.
If we're finally in a room that actually has proper sound isolation.
Soundproofing. We got, yeah. We're all good to go. Anyway, we're so thrilled to be back on the air with you guys. Laura and I did a show a couple of weeks ago with Bill Stillwell.
We did.
Back and Pat show, which
was a
huge show.
Fine
a lot of people.
Gentlemen.
Good show. Right. Yeah. Fine gentlemen. So if you're sitting there on Twitter and you have this itch to type in the letter COD3, then feel free to go ahead and or any Call of Duty, go listen to the Back and Bat and it'll explain it to you, right?
Was that big red one?
Black Ops 3. That's what they want. Black Ops
Oh,
3.
Black Ops 3.
They want Black
Never
Ops.
Mind.
Anyway, Laura.
Hello.
How was your Thanksgiving?
It was good.
Your American Thanksgiving. Was it?
Yes, it was.
Okay. Did you go
great
anywhere?
Meal.
Did you go
no,
anywhere?
Stayed home.
Okay. What about you, Albert?
I went to Hawaii.
Oh.
Guess what? No, we don't need to go any further, Jeffrey. Unless you went to like Maui or
also Hawaii. No, I brined that bird and it was
nice.
Tender and juicy and flavorful.
How long
Nailed
did you brine it?
About 12 hours. You don't want to go any more than that. It's just. It's bad news.
It turns into a salt lick.
Hey, I don't mind the salt lick.
Yeah, I know you don't. I know you don't. We're from the South, so. All right, we're going to jump in there. We got so much business to do, Laura. We got to talk about what we're playing. We got to talk about the Xbox news. There's so much to go over. We've got to talk. Albert's going to tell us. Albert's here is going to talk us about, talk us through
4K.
Huge thing. Xbox One S has been on sale. It was doing gangbusters over the holiday. It's still doing very well. A lot of people having questions. Hey, Albert, I see them tweeting to you. Hey, Albert, is this a good 4K TV? And they're tweeting you while they're shopping at like Best Buy or something.
I should get like a spiff.
Yeah.
Like I should get a cut when I sell a TV.
Yeah.
Albert Pinello, 4K help desk.
Yes.
But you're just going to kind of catch us up on the state of the state. We had you on probably right after we announced Xbox One S.
So yeah, you and I were talking a little bit about
yeah,
it.
Yeah, so we're gonna figure we'll have you on again, A, to dispel the Smith and you, Laura, not the same person.
Not the same person.
And B, to talk about that kind of stuff. But let's go through what we're playing. As a guest, you get to go first.
I knew you were going to ask me this.
Okay.
I'm not playing anything. I'm testing things right now.
Right.
I am in technology test mode right now.
Like, what are you testing?
Well, you know, there's a bunch of new devices that are out from us and from others, and now's the time to go and sort of like plug things in and do a plug fest and figure out how things work. You know, we might be launching something next year too, and so it's fun to look and see what our friends
so now people,
are
people,
doing.
People are stuck because they didn't hear anything past the word plug fest because they don't know what that is.
It doesn't.
Oh, is
doesn't
that like
sound good.
Is that like a super Microsofty term?
I think Laura.
Yes, I've never heard it.
Okay. It can go a lot of bad directions.
I've only heard it because when I joined the Xbox team with 360 back in the day, before we launched 360, we did a plug fest, which why don't you explain what it is?
Well, basically, you know, as you guys know, there's lots and lots of different TVs and lots of different devices, and to buy all that stuff would be very, very difficult and very costly. And so, what we had historically done was cut deals with retailers to come in at night.
After hours.
And plug our stuff in.
And
just plug our stuff into all the TVs and devices that they had and see if it worked.
And take notes.
And now, I don't think we do that quite as much anymore as we used to, but back in the scrappy days of,
I remember that.
OG Xbox and 360, we would like go to Best Buy in Bellevue at like 1 a.m. and just like turn on all the TVs and plug in and see what happened.
Mm-hmm. Right.
So they
That's true story.
That's fun.
Yeah,
I actually call those the plug fests.
Yeah,
right.
Very creative
youth. So you're doing
a plug fest. So I, it was... not as good of a joke as I thought it was.
I thought it was like a hair club for men thing. I didn't, yeah, that's where I got it.
There's probably an increasing number of people who could have that kind of plug fest here as well.
so you're playing the plug fest game.
I have a plug fest at my house.
Zero gamer score for that.
That's right. It doesn't show up.
Do you want to talk anything else you're playing?
Between that and vacation, no.
Okay, that's fair. You know, when you're on vacation, that's totally understandable because you're enjoying. In that case, you're soaking up the beautiful sun of
that's
the
right.
tropical
trying to get
islands.
My vitamin. What is it? B or D?
D.
That's what
that's the one we're all lacking. That's
right. Very much.
Very much at this point.
We're all pasty white. What about you, Laura? What are you playing? I know one of the ones you're continuing to play.
Yes. So it's probably no surprise to any listener or longtime listener that I've still been playing Diablo.
Yeah.
What?
I know, right? Gasp.
I know. They continue to make that game fun. Like, they just squeeze the life out of it. And, well, for me, I squeeze the life out of it as I try and, you know, get every last drop of fun out
you
of
do.
It. And I do. I still find the fun. Like, I can't actually do that. It's a continually fun game. And I was able to find something for you.
You did.
Have you opened it?
I haven't. So, why don't you explain this mechanic and what happened?
Yes. So, one of the best things about Diablo on the Xbox is the ability to gift things to your friends. You can gift things, but more importantly, the game embraces this and drops legendary gifts for your friends.
Right.
And everybody wants a legendary in Diablo. And
I didn't know it was legendary.
Yes, every gift is a legendary item. Exactly.
Right.
So they don't tell me what it is. It's just a little present that pops onto the screen and you pick it up and it says, "This is a gift for Major Nelson."
And which it was.
Would you like to send it to Major Nelson? And I was like, "Yes, I would."
So I will, by the next show, I will retrieve my, I apologize. I've been traveling, as you know. And
I'm disappointed.
Maybe it's a purple microphone.
I hope so.
Like straight out of The Price is Right.
I hope so.
The Sony, whatever that is.
DCM50.
That's the one.
So
that's the one.
I'm a microphone nerd, Albert. I'm sorry.
How great of a weapon would that be, by the way?
So that's, I do need to play this. So you're playing Diablo. You playing Solitaire?
Yes, I am.
Solitaire on iOS, Android.
What's your Solitaire gamer score?
You can get achievements.
Oh my gosh. Solitaire is hard, y'all. I have not won a single game yet, and I've played 10.
All right, now let me.
What?
So now, which version are you playing? Just straight up?
Classic.
Classic. Because here's the problem. I mean, I've been playing Solitaire, like many of you and listeners, for many years. I don't understand Klondike or Free Cell or any of that.
Well, Klondike is your basic one.
Okay, Klondike's a
basic. But you got to play Vegas Cumulative and get yourself into a big hole and imagine how you're going
to. Can I just tell you, it is also a lie. There is no Vegas Solitaire. I have been to Vegas.
I know.
I'm like practicing to go to Vegas to win a Solitaire. There is no Solitaire in Vegas. I've been lied to by Microsoft for years.
That's upsetting because I've gotten really good at that and I'm like ready to, I don't go to Vegas very often, but I'm ready to go and just take that town
if
and
you
for everything they're worth.
If you find Solitaire in Vegas, call me.
Attention, anyone in Clark County.
It's probably like the golden nugget.
Please report back if you find it. So you're playing Solitaire.
So I wouldn't go to Vegas to play Solitaire. I am terrible at it, apparently.
Are you doing the daily challenges?
I'm not.
I am.
That's where you get your big gamer
score. I got my coins, every night before I go to bed.
Nice.
Yeah.
Though I do play Spider Solitaire.
See, I don't understand.
It's much harder. So Klondike is very big. I've played them all to get the gamer score. I've got about 385 right now and many more to go. Mm-hmm. But Spider Solitaire, you only have like two suits, I guess. Mm-hmm. And then you have to like be a little more careful. And then Free Cell is sort of like a little bit different than that. But then the Pyramid or Tri-Peaks, whatever it's called, is actually really fun.
Okay, I should give that a try.
Yeah, they're all reasonably easy.
So wait a minute,
and the gamer,
Laura, you obviously know all these different versions of Solitaire because you're.
I've never played the Pyramid one.
Tri-Peaks.
All right.
So anyway,
Pre-Cell, Spire Solitaire.
Here's the deal.
That's where it's
on
at.
Android and iOS, and of course Windows 10. You download the app. You can sign in on your Android phone or your iOS phone, and you sign into Xbox Live. Mm-hmm. You get achievement and gamer score.
Yes.
So that's kind of it's free. That's kind of the takeaway here.
Free gamer score. As long as you can. Actually get it, unlike me, who's still in.
I've actually been getting it because I'm playing, like I said, I'm playing the daily for the basic, you know, game.
Very good.
I can't cheat at it.
I'm going to start it right now and
go ahead.
The show.
Go ahead. You're welcome to do that, Albert, until we call on you.
That's right. I will wait.
Until
asked.
I see. He's checked out. Now he's just playing Solitaire.
And thanks for coming on the show, Albert.
Thanks, Al.
You guys have me.
Adding value.
And then the rest of my holiday was very relaxed,
mm-hmm.
so I didn't get the chance to play too much more
other All right.
than that.
All
I've
right.
been decorating for the holidays and mm-hmm. getting ready. It's fun. Fun stuff.
Jeffrey.
So, it's been a while.
Yes, it has.
It has.
Laura and I did a show last time.
Your hair is twice as long.
I'm getting
time.
A cut like immediately after here. It's It's a problem. So
that is long.
It's about twice as long than when I saw him.
I just
him
noticed
last.
It when he turned his head. It's got that big, thing slipping going down on the side there. It's,
you know, I gotta appeal to Generation Z. Yeah. That's what I'm told.
Well, in this case, put your hoodie up.
Yeah, that's
okay. You gotta put your hoodie
best.
Up. There you go. That's it are. Right there.
Now I look like the dude from Watch Dogs. Segue. So after beating Titanfall 2, which is one of my favorite shooter campaigns, maybe ever.
Really.
Yes. Like Titanfall 1, you played it for multiplayer because, you know, that's what it was. And then I heard they were coming out with a campaign for 2. I was like, how good can it be? Well, it turns out really great. It's awesome. It's an excellent shooter campaign, as is Battlefield as well. And I was waiting for Dishonored 2 to come out. And in that meantime, I was like, well, you know, maybe I used to live in San Francisco. I'm just going to load up Watch Dogs 2 and I'm just going to drive around, see if I can mm-hmm. find my old house, mm-hmm. see how, you know, different landmarks and things are. I haven't put it down since.
Did you find your house?
What?
Did you find your house?
Oh, so the neighborhood I lived in.
The one you took me to?
What? Oh, yeah. So the mission is there, right. But not my particular street. Some of the streets, I'm like, oh, I know exactly. I'm going down Dolores Street. There's certain intersections.
Dolores!
Even, yes. Well, and there's also a Westworld thing here. It really works on so many levels.
That's what I connected with.
And like where my wife used to work, like that building, like the parking, like everything
is
exactly
that ice cream
there.
Place there that you took me to?
So the mission does not extend east of Mission Street, unfortunately. Okay. So they just have the gentrified part of the mission. But anyway, I got so hooked on it because I played the whole first Watch Dogs. Right. Actually, I was in Chicago last week for the first time since then.
Right.
And I was playing with my phone. You can't just lift bollards everywhere and make the street explode. I tried. So, but it's so much more lighthearted and just fun. Like, there's a lot of things that are really wrapped up amazingly so in like current events. Like, Martin Shkreli is kind of almost in that game. And
you hack Ubisoft. You go into Ubisoft. You have to
hack
Ubisoft.
Yes, you hack into Ubisoft, which is exactly where it's supposed to be on 3rd Street, I want to say, in Bryant.
I didn't come across Stone when I got in that office.
I was very upset that Stone Jim was not in the game.
Missed opportunity.
He's got to be in the game.
He's not.
He's somewhere.
I looked.
Come on.
I know. I agree.
But anyway.
Stone, if you're listening, can you please tell us where you are in the game, please?
It is a very fun game. And so I have like 815 gamer score. I'll beat it probably in the next day or so. I'm very close. But it just has a lot of heart, whereas the first one was like very technically cool. This one takes that and just adds like really likable characters.
So we were playing the other night, Jeff was playing, and I had fired it up as well, and I saw that he was playing, and they have this mechanic where you can go into someone else's game and hack them.
What?
Yeah.
Yes. And so what happens is, like, you know the hacker's there, but you can't see them. And what happens is then they have to stay a certain distance from you, and they're downloading data off of your phone, presumably. Right. So you have to try and find them before they finish the hack and then escape. And Larry, I couldn't find him. We're hanging out in the Alamo Square, and I'm like looking everywhere. So I end up.
And the little thing on my screen is going, I say 20%, 25%, 26%.
This is right up your screen.
So I send up like a drone, and I'm flying it all over. And it turns out Larry was just sitting 10 feet away from me on the other side of a tree that I didn't see. And I found him. And
I made a fatal mistake.
Yeah, very fatal.
Well, I had to get away. So I run around the corner. I can see him on my mini map. He's coming after me, and I jump in a car. And I take off.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah,
this was great. So you can hack cars in this game. They're all smart cars. Yep. So he starts to speed off. I'm standing in the middle of the street, and I'm like, "Oh no, you don't!"
Oh no!
And I hold down like the left bumper, and I hit I think the A button, and immediately he starts rolling backwards. He gets out of the car, and good night.
He guns me down.
Good night, Major Nelson. So,
a lot of fun though.
That is a very fun mechanic, and I tend to have like these cat and mouses with it, where you just go on forever. Another game that actually we were playing together. Is Dead Rising 4.
Oh, yeah.
This week.
That just came out.
And it's got a separate co-op mode, and we were playing the four-player co-op, where it's just you're in the mall, and you have a few objectives to do, but it's just madcap fun.
If you like killing zombies, it's just stupid, silly fun.
Oh, yeah.
That's it.
You
want to
bash them with, you know, Nerf guns or
I had this presents. Weird ping-pong gun, you know.
Yes.
I was shooting ping pong balls
at
zombies.
Was that effective?
That's not at all, Laura. Yeah. Not at all. It was the worst weapon in the entire game.
I can imagine. It was just
And it made that sound, you know, when you shoot anyway. So it was a lot. That was fun though. We did that good co-op.
Yeah, we did. So highly recommend the co-op. I'm still playing through. I'm actually playing the campaign on Windows 10, and we were playing on Xbox on multiplayer.
Yeah, we had a lot of fun with that. So is that all you got? Because I got a couple things.
That's all I've got.
Of course, I'm playing. You know, we talked about Watch Dogs. I'm chipping away at that. The single player, doing a little co-op. Mm-hmm. Little Dead Rising 4. I'm playing Call of Duty: Modern Warfare Remastered on my Windows 10 PC. It looks great, and
right. It does. Look
and,
good.
And I think it's 4K. It looks fantastic. Final Fantasy. Fantasy, Jeffrey.
15. I'm saving that.
That one's special.
Did you start it?
Yeah, I did. Okay. I started. I'm probably about 2.5 hours in. So awesome.
I'm very impressed that you're playing that game. It just feels like a large game.
The writing is actually very good. The voice acting mm-hmm. is very good. The writing is very good. The combat. I made a mistake though in the game. You know, it's if you go out at night, the enemies are very difficult. And I was like, it's nighttime. What could go wrong? Well, a lot.
Oh, no.
It goes back to my old adage that I'm pretty convinced that nothing good ever happens after midnight. Yeah. It actually carries over into video games. I would like to point out that as we go through this, I look across to the end of the table and Albert is still playing solitaire.
Yes, he is.
Okay. He is.
Have you won yet?
Are you talking to me?
Yeah, exactly. So anyway, that's kind of what I'm playing, but I figured we'd have a chance to go through the news. I want to talk about a couple things I'm going to be doing. I just got, of course, Laura, when you joined the show, or when you and I did the show last time, we talked about my time in Australia and Mexico. I'm headed to New York next week. I haven't even told you this, Laura.
What?
I don't think Jeffrey.
More travel for Larry?
I'm headed to New York. I was invited by Fox Pictures to go interview the stars for Assassin's Creed for the film.
Michael Fassbender.
Yeah, so I'm going to go.
Ask him about Alien.
I'm going to.
You'd love that.
So I'm going to talk. We're going to talk to him about that. I'm actually doing two things on Monday. So we're recording this and posting this on Friday. On Monday, I'm doing a Facebook live stream. So we'll do Q&A on Facebook mm-hmm. Live. Just follow me on Major Nelson. I'll tell you all the details, and then I'll go hang out with the stars the next day and so forth.
Say hi to Marianne Cotillard for me.
I will do that. You seem to be very enamored with this young woman.
We.
She's very French.
Yeah, that's obviously French.
Do you mean we as in
we?
Both of you or all of us?
That's why I took it. We as
all
in yes.
All of the above.
Anyway, so it's I'll be in New York on Monday and Tuesday, so look for my tweets from that, and hopefully you guys and girls can tune in on that Facebook live. Do you have any questions you'd like to ask Michael Fassbender? Laura?
I'll have to think about that one.
Okay. Are you a Michael Fassbender fan? You know who else is in it? Is Jeremy Irons. Who I just...
Let me guess. He's the bad guy.
I don't know, but he's got such a great voice.
He was Alfred in Batman Superman, so maybe he's trying to change his
image.
Oh, I
didn't see Batman and Superman.
Yeah, I didn't.
Versus Superman.
So... I don't think a lot of people did. So, anyway,
yeah, it only made like 2 billion.
Why don't you ask him about that?
So I'll be in.
I want to know if Fassbender, if he had to cut his finger off for the role.
I will. I'll do a full report back. Hopefully, we can do a show next week because I've got a lot of travel going on. I'm going to be doing that. Come back and then we hit right into because next week, Albert.
Yes.
Next week.
Next week.
Next week.
Next week.
Star Wars.
Oh yes.
That is
huh.
Do you have tickets?
Never heard of it.
Never heard of it. So are you? Do you have your Rogue One tickets?
Because I know. Of course, I got my Rogue One.
Okay,
tickets.
I know Laura and I were chatting. She has hers. Jeffrey, you have yours.
Yeah, we're seeing it 10 a.m. on
and,
Friday.
And so when are you going to see it?
One o'clock.
Yeah. Okay, on Thursday
I'll
or Friday?
Come out spoiling
Friday.
It.
So I think I see it earliest because
yes,
I see it 7 o'clock
on Thursday.
Thursday night. Although
Thursday.
I think I may or may not have a screening before that. That's all I can say. Know. So
special. And who are you taking to that screen? You have a screen out there saying
Albert who?
And
yes. So I'll let you know about that. But yeah, so we got a lot to talk about next week, hopefully.
Yeah, and yeah, Larry and I sat together on text messages like, "Have you gotten tickets yet? Is anything working for you?"
Yeah, because everything went crazy with that.
Then we were both ready.
The internet melted down. Where are you seeing it, Albert?
I'm just seeing it at Crossroads.
Okay.
I think it was mostly around people who aren't like us and can't get off in the middle of the day to go see movies. So if you try to go that night or the night before, you're stuck.
Right.
But I didn't have any problems going in the afternoon.
Yeah.
So.
That's all right.
I am working from home that day.
Yes, yes. Plug fest.
Also, yeah. I think I'm coming up with something.
Yeah, so we're down with it. So.
There we are.
Anyway, so
let's edit that down and just go straight to the part where you're not feeling well.
Star Wars will be next week. We'll have a full report on that. But anyway, I just want to let folks know I'll be in New York next week. Very, very quick turn. I leave on Sunday, Monday, back Tuesday night. So
that is a quick turn.
Hopefully, you guys can have some good questions for that. I'll hit you up on Twitter, everyone listening, for your questions if you have any specific questions for them around the movie. I'm just excited to talk to them about Assassin's Creed. I mean, who hasn't played that franchise, right? And talk about what they're going to do there.
Is it Fassbender, is he Altair or Ezio?
We'll find out.
Ooh, okay.
So we'll find out. Anyway, and then apparently, like, they invited me to go to Good Morning America, which is a big TV show.
Are you going to be on Good Morning
America? Well, no, I'm not going to be on it, but they're doing something with a stuntman where they're going to have him do the leap of faith.
They're going to let you on.
Like, I don't know how high up he's going to be in Times Square, because you know where Good Morning America is right in Times Square in New York City. So
there's a lot of tall buildings.
There's a lot of tall buildings there. But there a lot of tall buildings, very few haystacks.
Didn't I read that they did, like, the biggest live jump, like, of all time? It's, like, the tallest stunt ever, right?
Before the leap of faith.
Oh, my God.
That was, most of it's real.
Yeah.
Now I want to see it.
I know.
Anyway, so I'll more details on that, but we've got a lot of Xbox news. Jeffrey, you have some things in front of you want to go through.
I do indeed.
So why don't we tap through those, because we're a little bit tight on time, but I want to, after this, we're going to get to Albert to talk about 4K, and then Laura, we've got to name the game. We have so much to do.
So the big release for the week, as you well know, was Dead Rising 4.
Dead Rising 4.
On Xbox One and Windows 10.
Did you see the video I did?
I haven't watched that yet.
I did a video where I interviewed, Laura, you didn't see this, as you don't have any time. I interviewed a zombie expert.
There's such a thing.
What? I'll link to it. Jeffrey,
I'll drop that in the notes.
It was an interview I did with a actual, this gentleman prepares people for zombie attacks, and I interviewed him.
I would love to see that.
Well, thank
you. Very interesting.
I will make sure I put that out.
10 tips to survive the zombie apocalypse.
Yep, that's it.
Another big update, and that would be for Halo 5 Forge. So as you know, this is something that is available for free on Windows 10. And something that I thought was really interesting is that, and I'll just read the quote here, with this powerful new feature, Halo 5 Forge on Windows 10 graduates to a full-fledged Halo Arena multiplayer experience, letting you search, find, and join games to play at 4K for free.
Yep.
So if you've got a Windows 10 computer with...
What are you waiting for?
Yeah, exactly.
There should be nothing holding you back.
So
it's
big
free.
Update there. Another game that I hadn't heard in a little while, now available also for Xbox One and Windows 10.
Yes.
As part of game preview, is Gigantic.
Yeah.
So this is sort of a MOBA shooter, and you can play it right now for free.
What are you waiting for? Xbox and Windows 10.
Yes. Get those downloads going. Bethesda Pinball. So for Zen Pinball, the Pinball FX people, they tend to make
They're the
really
only ones
cool...
that do pinball games, really.
Well, like, you have, like, the real pinball games from the Pinball Arcade, which is an ID at Xbox game, which is great if you want to play really, like, pixel-perfect replications of real pinball tables, which is actually really fun. If you want the fantasy side, Pinball FX, also available for ID at Xbox. I really love their Plants vs. Zombies table.
Yep.
But now there are tables for Skyrim, for Fallout, and for Doom.
Awesome.
So very anxious to see those.
Larry, didn't you and I do a stream on one of their tables?
We did. Was that the Star Wars table?
I don't know. Which table was it?
They did
it
do
a
bunch of Star Wars ones.
Well, I think it was Portal. That's right.
Portal
good
table.
Memory.
Laura,
good memory.
That was a really fun one.
Yeah, those are really good tables.
Goat Simulator Payday.
Right.
You have Goat Simulator.
I love Goat Simulator.
And you have Payday.
It's a great game.
I have no idea how the two of those go together.
You know either.
I think both the developers are Swedish. There's a good Zlatan reference in there.
There you go.
Anyway.
They met at a coffee shop, and now they're trying to do work together.
Yes. And then We Happy Few had a big update.
Yeah.
So as you remember, that hit Xbox game preview right around E3 or just after E3. They have been listening, and they have made a significant update called the Clockwork Update, which is now available.
Delightful. Delightful. So lots going on. Now, here's something you need to know. Look, don't worry about it. You miss something now, you're confused, you're hurt, you're scared, you're huddling in a corner, you're like, I don't know. Tune in every Friday on your Xbox console. I'll tell you what to play with this week on Xbox. You can see it on your Xbox console, YouTube, on Twitter, pretty much everywhere, Laura.
Yeah, pretty much everywhere.
So you can't swing a dead cat without missing this week on Xbox. I'll make sure you see it. So there's a lot going on there, a lot of game releases, but Albert's joining us after he's going to finish Solitaire.
Yep. Have you won yet?
I'm that close.
You are close.
Ooh, you are close.
Yeah, I told you.
But Albert, I want to get you on because Xbox One S, of course, is the only console that has a 4K Blu-ray player.
That's correct.
Are you surprised by that?
I'm shocked. Yes, actually.
Okay.
But please...
Good. So what else would you like to tell us? I mean, I wanted to get you on to talk about, there's people that are out going now, certainly they're picking up an Xbox One S, and they're talking about the games, you know, which games are in HDR, what TV do I get, what's the state of it, you know, those kind of things. I figured you can kind of recap what's going on. Now, you have this crazy, banana, crazy HDR TV at home you were telling me about.
I think you
mortgaged the house for this thing.
Again,
plug fest.
Yeah, exactly. So I obviously had a little bit of a heads up that we might be doing some stuff with some 4K things on hardware. everywhere.
Right.
So I actually jumped the gun and bought my TV a lot earlier. Actually, I think I bought it late last year.
I think you did.
Bought it late last year. And so I'm a super early adopter pre-gen, but I bought an LG OLED.
Right.
Because I also watch a lot of movies and things like that. So
what are you watching now?
Well, now I'm going back and watching a bunch of cool stuff. They're just releasing a bunch of 4K, some of the older stuff. So
yeah,
it's fun to watch like kind of modern movies, like the Star Treks they did, the 09 Star Trek they did in 4K, and obviously Deadpool, Mad Max.
Wait a minute, 09 is old? I mean,
the old new Star Treks, the new okay. Star Treks, old ones? Movies, new Star Treks.
Yeah.
The JJ first ones?
The JJ first okay. ones, which look great in 4K, and Deadpool, Mad Max, which is like one of my favorite movies in the last awesome. Few years, looks awesome. So, yeah, it's been fun watching people. It's the thing that's interesting about this to me is that when we did 360 in HD, kind of that stuff was already in market when we launched.
Yeah,
we were right cresting it a little bit before. Maybe
it depends on what you looked at.
I bought an HD TV just for my Xbox. There was actually
720p.
As did I.
Yeah,
yeah.
But there were 720p TVs out in the OG Xbox. So
right.
So that had
we had the HD pack, right?
Yeah, that's right. Well, yeah, we had the adapter for it, and so. It was possible to be because there was DVI back then. It was all before HDMI, so it was different with VGA to get into that. But the point is that like a lot of that stuff had kind of worked out, and here we're really on the cusp of 4K kind of coming out.
Right.
So there's just I see a lot more confusion with customers.
What are some of the things you see that you want that you'd like to talk about?
Well, the first thing is that you've got. That you have the different technologies, right? So you have OLED and you have LED sort of, so there's questions about that. There's people are more attuned to input latency for their gaming. So
right.
It's like not really a question. You never had to ask that question in the CRT days.
Right.
People didn't know to ask the question in sort of the early
I had a 16:9 CRT, the Toshiba. This thing had to weigh 300 pounds.
Oh, I bet.
It was ginormous, and it was probably about 4 feet deep. It was huge.
Yeah, and now you've got a flat panel that you can sort of pick up with your pinky.
Right, it's crazy.
It's so thin. So I think there's questions about that. There's questions about input latency. HDR continues to be a big
high
question.
Dynamic range.
Right, high dynamic range continues to be a question. And I think that the industry hasn't sorted out. You've got the HD premium certification, and you've got Dolby Vision, and you've got...
Now, Xbox One S supports what?
So HDR 10 is the the movie standard, right. Sort of the baseline
right.
Of HDR support. So if your TV supports HDR, it supports HDR 10.
Mm-hmm.
You can think of Dolby Vision as kind of like THX, like it will have additional requirements on top of that.
Sure.
But
those are the two main. I mean, anything else you hear out there, that's just kind of noise.
Yeah.
Those are the two standards.
Those are the two main standards.
Yeah.
And so if it's almost certain that if you're buying a... Dolby Vision said it supports HDR 10, but it might not necessarily be the other case. And then there's just silly things like not every TV calls these features the same thing. Some
right.
have them on by default, some have them off, some require specific ports.
That's the one thing that I noticed, I remember from last time, and a lot of people hit me up on Twitter and send me emails is like, you know, yeah, you may have an HDR TV, but maybe it only has input one. And you have your console and input too, so you're like, why isn't it working?
Well, so my set, for instance, is that way.
Right? Oh, really? Okay.
My set only has one input that supports HDR.
Right.
Even though three of them support 4K.
Right.
Only one of them.
So you got to kind of have to read the fine print.
Yeah. And there's AV. A lot of people have AV receivers, AVRs them that might not support passing 4K. So it's kind of complicated. And I feel bad for customers. Because, you know, it's very easy to think like, did I buy the TV's fault or it's Xbox's mm-hmm. did something wrong?
What's going on here?
Yeah, well,
that's why when you buy your Xbox One S, we've got this nifty little screen and display that, assuming everything works, you get green check marks all the way down the line.
Oh, that's good.
It's like check, 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 check. And it kind of, you know, so you don't have to keep firing up a game. Does it look good? I don't know. Does the TV say? I don't know. We kind of take care of that for you.
And then you can sort of work your way through the problem from there. But there's some good sets of basics. So, I would say from a TV buying perspective, if you're buying something this year, you're in good shape. Like you're going to go with Samsung, you're going to go with Sony, you're going to go with LG, you're going to go with Vizio. These right. are all names you know. What can you afford?
Right.
What do you care about?
How big do you need it?
Et cetera. How big? Right. So it's like I'm not really going to say like there's a good
best.
One or a bad one.
Right.
There are actually really good things about all of them, and there's generally some thing you wish was better on all.
Yeah,
of them
I
as
ran
well.
Into a problem because I my TV's at home. I was kvetching about this on Twitter earlier in the week, is I had to do my TV doesn't do pass through for 5.1. So I plug my HDMIs into my TV, and it's a Samsung TV, and output optical out into my soundbar, and it's like, no, I'm not going to pass 5.1. So I'm trying to figure that fiasco out. It's just, and then I went down the rabbit hole of, oh, I wonder why this doesn't work. Let me go to AVS form. Yeah. Okay. 2.5 hours later, I still don't have an answer, but I had some great reading.
Yeah. And there's also this thing called ARC, which is called audio return channel, which will then go back into the receiver. So everybody that's used to plugging into the receiver, then to the TV, you can actually make it go the other way now.
But why?
That's right. Which is, so anyway, there's a lot there.
What's your best source? If I didn't, you know, if the listeners want to know, where
Twitter.com/AlbertPinello.
I'm sure he'd love that.
You know, honestly, you really have got to read a lot of different sources. Yeah. I think the answer to that question is, what are you trying to optimize for? If you're trying to optimize for games, go to the games forums. The games forums have really good threads about buying TVs for gaming. If you care about video primarily, then I would go to something like AVS Forum, that'll help you pick something that's more optimized for movie watching and video watching, because they are different activities and the TVs have to compromise, which is why you have things like Vivid Mode and Cinema Mode and Game Mode, because you know, TVs and DVDs and animation and games all have slightly different requirements. So it's complicated.
Right. And we also want to point out that there's a lot of games on Xbox One that support HDR.
Yes.
You know, we've got, I know that Forza Horizon 3 looks delightful. Delightful. Gears of War 4, breathtaking if you have an Xbox One S or a PC and HDR. Well, actually, so on the PC side, what's going on there with HDR? That's even more confusing, isn't
it? Yeah, that's probably, you're going to start seeing that stuff probably next year.
Okay.
Again, it's very easy to think that all these things do the same thing.
Right.
But like, it's a screen with pixels. And so, but, you know, you don't need HDR in desktop productivity software. And so the drive to do
nothing
HDR,
looks better than my pivot table. And
that's right.
HDR. Excel HDR.
PowerPoint is the most vivid it's ever been. And so there's a lot of questions about, the refresh rates have to be a lot different. The PC cards have to support, you have a lot more different cards.
Yeah.
So they're going to be probably a little slower to adopt HDR, but, from our conversations with them, that's probably something you're going to start to see end of 2017.
Yeah, figure that out. Yeah.
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 But yeah, there's games coming out. And again, this is the thing I kind of like to remind people is when everybody asks when, is like, we're just in the beginning of this. So games and game developers and TV manufacturers, we all have to sort of get used to.
And figure it out.
Figure this out. What works? What do customers want?
This reminds me a little bit. I know it's not the same in terms of technology, but it reminds me a little bit of the early days of achievements.
Yeah.
Where people, you know, Xbox 360 brought on this concept of achievements. And we all had those games like, well, that does achievements weird or that. And so then developers start having fun with it and figuring it out. Now they're kind of got into this rhythm, right? So you just, they got to figure it out. There's this new, it's a new tool in the toolbox and they got to figure it out.
And showing it to people is really hard
because
showing people what 4K and HDR looks like, is really hard when you're not watching the thing in 4K or in HDR.
Mm-hmm. Right.
So, you know, how do we market that and be honest? You have to fudge things a little bit to show the differences, but you want to do it in a way that's honest.
Right.
So even telling customers what it looks like, you know, we have to go through that journey.
It's like describing a smell. You can't really describe a smell, right?
You just have to smell it.
Right. You got to smell it. Mm-hmm. What does HDR smell like, Albert?
Delicious.
like muffins coming out of the oven on a...
Like a crisp warm spring day. I would just say there's a couple basic things I want to just sort of remind everybody as they're going through this, which is like, there's lots of great TVs and I wouldn't be afraid to jump in, no pun intended, to buying a TV because I think you can wait forever, but there's plenty of good options out there. We have two things that I always point people towards, and Larry, you point out one of them, which is we have the 4K troubleshooter that goes through
on your console.
On the console. And we also have a HD calibration utility that's in the video settings.
Yep.
And both of those things are super important to make sure not only that you have everything actually in 4K, but most people don't know that the TVs, the way they're default set up, are not really actually the best picture quality. They're brighter, they're sharper than they need to be. They look a little unnatural. And so we have a great calibration utility that people can go through and really, and Larry, I've done this to your TVs. You always see when I walk into a room.
Yeah, we walk into our studios.
And I complain about the sharpness on your television.
And then we get into this 2-hour slippery slope conversation. Once you leave, then everyone is like, well, what about this? What about, anyway.
This is like when I go home and my mom's watching SD stuff in stretched out to 16:9.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, that's right.
The VCR lights blinking.
There's a whole in-laws thing.
Do you remember, are we, by the way, finally passed this full screen video thing? Remember that was in the 90s when you get a video and it's like, do you want letterbox or full screen, right?
Well, now the TVs are in the right aspect ratio.
Yeah, so. Right.
But again, so I remind people, like, use the HDMI cable that comes in our box. There really is a difference in what formats the HDMI can support.
Sure.
There is a quality of cable difference. When you're first getting started, plug it right into your television. Don't go through an AV receiver because that will eliminate a lot of issues that we see customers have. That doesn't mean you can't try later, but start in your TV.
Remove as many variables as you can and just get the signal straight and get it working the way you want it first. Exactly. And then start slowly adding in components or variables so that you don't have to like unwind it.
Yeah. And look, when you get it running, it's really, you know, we've all seen stuff in 4K and HDR, mm-hmm. and we don't, you know, I think historically, we don't always support every single format war that comes out or every single industry standard, but I think this is like one of those cases where I think 4K personally is really awesome. I know the team's really behind it. I know we're listening to a lot of feedback online.
Yeah.
As people are having setup issues, the TV manufacturers are being way better about responding and doing patches and updates.
Well, that's also the bonus of the fact we live in this connected world.
Yeah.
Where your TV's online, it's taking a firmware update and doing all that stuff. So yeah, it's good stuff.
So it's a good time. It's a good time. Good Christmas gift. Put it on your Santa list.
Yeah. I mean, I need to go out and get a new TV because I bought mine before the HDR thing. Revolution, for lack of a better term. So I'm
do you have a 4K set?
I have two.
But they're pre-HD.
But they're mm-hmm. right before HD. And some of they're trying to super HD. They're trying to pawn them off as like HDR, but they're not. I know they're not. Come on. Don't do that to me.
That's yeah.
So anyway, so yeah, we'll have that's good stuff. Now there's another great resource, which Jeff will put a link to in the show notes, which is there's a great article on Xbox Wire. Kind of preps you for HDR, and the team has updated that, haven't they?
Yes, they
recently
have.
So that's good to know. So that's something you need to.
And it lists out the different games that are already supporting HDR, and mentions a few that we know going forward are going to. So
yeah, we're gonna have some big app announcements coming up soon. We're always adding new 4K content, so there's gonna be more game releases and app releases coming up.
I need to see NBA 2K17 in HDR. That's always like the NBA series.
Jeffrey has Dean always Chameleon been.
Yeah, I know. I was gonna ask, what's your name again?
Jeffrey Dean Chameleonaire. Which I feel a little weird because now Jeffrey Dean Morgan is the uber bad guy in Walking Dead right now, but whatever. Has nothing to do with my basketball career. But that's always the game I would show off in HD because, like, this gen, it's one of the consistently best-looking games. Yep. Like, the one where people walk by and go, who's playing? And then you realize, oh, wait, you are. Yeah. Not the real Dubs.
Well, first of all, Albert, that's really good information. And you're always welcome to come on the show, you know, to talk about and give us a state of the HDR. Now, of course, one of the main reasons you came on the show is really to give up all the new Scorpio news. No.
Oh, you're killing me, dude.
We'll have news on that in 2017, people. But it's always great to have you on the show.
Scorpio, never heard of it.
Never. What is that?
What is that?
I don't know what that is. You got all those notes there, Jeff? You're going to throw in there?
Oh, yeah.
All right, we're gonna stop and do a name the game, Laura.
Yeah,
because we really cook, because I've got a bunch of stuff. I got to do some TV. I got to prep for Michael Fassbender.
That's right.
Okay?
He you seems like, you better give him a good question or he's just going to throw right back at you. He doesn't have time for... you know, what's your favorite holiday recipe?
I ask thoughtful.
I know you do. I'm intense. Just saying, you're going
to
need that.
It takes time to prepare.
Yeah. All right. So, all right. Laura, you ready for Name the Game?
I am ready. of those sounds were from Name the Game from last time.
Yep.
And it was Farming Simulator. Let me try that again.
Yep.
Farming Simulator 17.
Yep.
Love that game.
I know you do. And you and I have yet to do it in multiplayer.
We have not done multiplayer yet.
Apparently because there's no dungeons to raid. Okay.
They should add that as a content.
Yes, I know. I know. They
Farming Simulator.
Content, yeah, okay.
Raid the dungeons. All right, I'm sure you guys don't care about our banter.
Raid the pigsty.
You want to hear
Who is the winner? Who is the winner?
The winner is John from Iowa.
Okay, that's good to know.
His gamer tag is Waffle House Ninja.
That's a great gamer tag.
That is a great. You've been to Waffle House, haven't you?
I have, yes.
I have too. Jeffrey, you haven't been to a Waffle House until you've been to a Waffle House in Florida.
You mentioned that nothing good happens after midnight. I've never been to a Waffle House before midnight.
Okay. Yes. And am I right?
Look, yes. Who's won. What do you, who's hold on a second. To
stop. Are you going to
hold the presses?
You want to win right now?
Yeah, this is totally legit. Okay. So I fired it up.
You started being a game.
His first game.
Laura has said this is
hard.
This is technically, I did not beat the first one. I played. This is my second game. Okay. I'm going to press the king of diamonds, yes. And then I'm going to win my first Solitaire
game. And then I think you have to say, don't you have to put a winner? There, oh, look, yeah.
we got the bounces.
It's even doing the animation.
So there you go. Number two, second game played, won it real time.
Maybe I should give you my phone so you can win. Get me the gamer
Not
score.
Also spilling mad info, but
you want to take that one again?
All right, now, Laura, we named the winner, but we didn't tell him what they won.
Yes, John is very curious about what he has
won.
What
have you, so now you went into my, I saw you rustling around in my office the other day, so you must have found some good stuff because you were in there giggling for quite some time.
You have a lot of good stuff in your office.
Yes.
You won't notice the things that is missing.
What did you find for Waffle House?
So Waffle House has won a copy of Headlander,
yes.
Which is a new Double Fine game.
Have you seen this where you have to be the head off one, you take the head of you being a robot?
Oh my gosh, it's just a brilliant concept.
All right.
And also a new game called Abzu,
yep.
Which is...
really good.
Oh.
It's really good.
Oh, you played it.
Yeah. It's sort of like an underwater exploration game.
All the words I love to hear.
But it's totally trippy. Yes, okay. It's great.
Abzu.
All right, and that's not all.
But what?
I know.
What did you get?
He also gets a copy of Dishonored 2.
Right? Dishonored 2, Jeffrey, fantastic. Playing that?
No, soon.
Soon.
When I'm done Watch Dogs.
And?
Yes.
And? A copy of Dead Rising 4.
That's right.
Wow.
Because you need to kill some zombies.
Exactly, and that's not all.
Wait.
John also gets a Xbox wireless controller, the blue version.
See, that's
a
good one. See what we're doing here?
Nice. Yeah.
This show gives away big stuff.
Big prizes. Big prizes. Can we throw in a copy of the Microsoft Solitaire collection?
Oh, that's for free.
We're looking at Albert's activity feed. He's unlocked since the cast started, since the show started, 65 gamer score.
Oh, really?
Yes.
Well done.
Boom.
Well done.
Can we go back to the beginning? What are you playing? I'm playing Solitaire.
Anyway, so that's...
Shall we do another Name the Game?
Yeah. Well, you tell me. You have one ready?
Yeah. All right. Let's roll the next Name the Game. So that was Name the Game for this week. If you would like to win fabulous prizes, it's super easy. All you have to do is send me an email, lollipop@xbox.com and ccmajor@xbox.com, mm-hmm. And just tell us what game that's from.
And if you don't know what it is and you're frustrated, just send us an email and say hello.
That's true. We always like to hear.
We won't enter you, but we'd love to say hello.
Yes. We'd love to hear from our listeners.
If you have any questions about HDR and 4K, we'll link to Albert. Now, usually when I have you on the show, I link to your Twitter profile.
Sure.
Is that okay? Do you even read
better
it?
Than my? Of course, absolutely, yeah. The time.
Okay,
When we launched Xbox One S, I really was like, you know, Albert Pinello was the 4K setup source.
Yeah, sorry for the internet.
I spent 2 days responding to people.
Thank you for calling help desk.
That's right.
Anyway, so all right, so that's we're doing Name the Game. So did you tell people to call? And all
yes,
this?
I okay. did. I told them to call. Yeah, they have all the instructions.
Okay,
don't worry, Larry. You'll listen to the show later.
Yeah. We'll figure it out.
What? I'm trying to keep the train on the tracks here. What do you got over there, Jeffrey?
Well, I'm looking at the fact that it jogged my memory. Farming Simulator, mm-hmm. That Stardew Valley is out next week on Xbox One.
Now that's a game similar to Farming Simulator, is it not?
It's more fantastical. It's sort of a
are there unicorns?
Reminiscent of Harvest Moon.
Are there dungeons?
Guess, in a way.
Interesting. I could go for dungeons.
Possibly. I actually haven't played it yet, but it's like a farming RPG, and it's very popular. And we'll have it next week.
Okay.
Oh.
No, it's going to be, you're going to be playing this game. This is your next jam.
So I don't know what our, I got to tell you, I don't know what our schedule is next week, our recording schedule. because I've got to New York. I've got New York. I've got to come home. We've got to shoot a couple of weeks of this week on Expo. Are you available next week, Laura?
I am. Okay. It's on my calendar.
Albert, would you like to join us? Okay, here's the deal, Albert. You are welcome to join us if you can unlock another 65 gamer score in a week.
Easy.
That's so many, isn't it?
Not in solitaire.
That's so many.
And Jeff, play Freestyle, you're there.
Jeff, you'll be here next week, right?
A little bit. So hopefully if we keep it where we normally record, I'm good.
You're good. Yeah, that's right. Because you're headed, you got some holiday plans. Laura, I know you've got some busy holiday schedule.
Yeah.
Oh, actually, what about you? What are you going to be doing, Albert? Are you going to stay here or are you going to go to Hawaii?
I wish I could be going to Hawaii. No, we're going to do the family thing.
What about you, Jeffrey? You're headed
back to the area. Heading to Europe.
You're heading overseas. That's exciting.
Ooh, that's fun.
I'm doing the anti-family thing. And we're going to Iceland.
I actually just booked it. I'm going to be headed back east. I'm going to go see my family. I'm going to be doing a couple appearances at some Microsoft stores.
Mm. All right.
So Danbury, Connecticut, I'm coming your way. I owe you. I've told you for 3 years I'm coming your way. We're going to do it.
Awesome.
Danbury's in the middle of nowhere, Laura.
There's a Microsoft store in Danbury, Connecticut?
Yeah.
Wow.
It's kind of on the west, right on the border to New York State. It's out on 84, and it's I've been there quite a few times, but it's a schlep, as we say.
Do they have like a Kramer of you on the wall? I sort of envision that you would be like the patron saint.
There's a sandwich named after him.
There isn't, but they do take a lot of the stores take this week on Xbox and they roll it on a loop. So mm-hmm. when I go into a store, I see myself.
It's the number one complaint from the employees.
If you want to sell more stuff, get press pause. Don't show me. Anyway, so we've got busy holiday. Hopefully, we're going to do an end of year show. I don't know when. I don't know how. I don't know where. But we're still here. The good news is we have to keep doing the show because we have this brand new beautiful studio. So I guess that means we're going to be in business for a while. So anyway, do you have anything else you want to add before we wrap up here? I know I'm kind of rushing people along, but we've got a lot to do.
All right, well, let's do those things, and we'll catch up later on devices.
Albert, thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you for having me. I love coming here. Laura and I are not the same person.
Yes. You're nuts.
She decided to show up when I show up.
We are different people.
I took a shower last night. I smell okay. Got my best Batman shirt on.
Well, actually, we have a little bit of a problem, because Laura and I go back and forth who's Batman, and now you're
I'm Batman.
He's entered his hat into the ring.
I know, he has, hasn't he?
Sort of pushed that hat back out.
Accidentally.
I'm Batman.
But thank you, Laura. I want to thank you for joining us as always. And you, dear listener, I want to thank you for finding the time for downloading the show and taking the time out of your busy day to listen to this. And thank you for all your support of Xbox. And we'll see you guys next time. You can follow us on Twitter. Jeffrey?
At Jeff Rubenstein.
Albert. At Albert Pinello.
And?
At Laura Lollipop.
Find me at Major Nelson. We'll talk to you guys next time. Bye-bye, everybody.
Bye-bye.
Bye.